Now, in our next lesson, we'll be talking about push buttons, which again, you can access by dragging one out from the components list over on the right. Before we put one in a breadboard, though, we're going to talk a little bit about how these are wired internally. So you should be familiar with the circuit symbol for a push button or switch. We're not going over circuit schematics in this video series. Here's the symbol for a basic push button with two terminals. When the switch is open, it's separated like this, and when the switch is closed, the lines are in contact, so you have a closed circuit from left to right. So the basic symbol for this only has two terminals, and that can make these buttons a little confusing since they have four pins. So the basic idea here is that you can think of it as a push button connected between two wires, and these wires then straddle the middle gap of the breadboard. So I have two buttons on my breadboard here straddling that center gap. So when this button is not pushed, each pair of pins is connecting the opposite sides of the breadboards. So for example, this hole over here is connected to this hole over here, even if the button is not pushed. Same for this hole here, everything across row 9 is connected, but row 7 is not connected to row 9 unless I push the button. So down here, you can see I have the schematic. If this button is pushed down, then all of the holes in row 11 and all of the holes in row 13 will all be connected to each other by that closed switch interior to the button. And again, you can represent that schematically over here where you think of the button connected in between two wires. So when you add the button to your circuit, you need to be careful about your breadboard orientation. You see here that the button doesn't actually fit across the middle of my breadboard because of how I have my breadboard rotated, so I also need to rotate the button so it fits across the center gap like that. What you want to be careful not to do is put the button off to the side like this, because this won't functionally do anything. So here I am connecting row 8 to row 11, because remember, these pins are always connected to each other, but when I push the button, that isn't going to accomplish anything because all of the holes in row 11 are already connected to each other internally, as are all of the holes in row 8. So in this configuration, pushing the button will not do anything. So in general, it's good practice to have the button across the middle gap of your breadboard like this. So now that we know how to connect the button, let's use a button to do something like put it in series with an LED so we can use it to turn the LED on and off. I'm going to demonstrate that here by adding an LED. Again, the orientation of the LED may be a matter of personal preference. I'm going to connect one end of the LED to my power bus. The other end of the LED, now rather than going directly to a resistor, is going to go to one side of the button. And then I'm going to add my resistor on the other side of the button and to the ground bus. So I'm going to put the resistor here. Remember, drop my resistor value a bit. And then wire this end of the resistor to ground. Now when I start my simulation, the LED will not light up unless I click the button, which I can do with my mouse. Now, if you want to edit your circuit, you need to stop the simulation first. So just to demonstrate, there are multiple ways to wire this correctly. I could have put the resistor on this side and put a wire to ground over there. And again, because of how the button is connected internally, which we went over earlier in the video, the LED will still light up in this case. What I don't want to do is put the resistor on the top part of the button here, like this, because then you will see when I start the simulation, the LED will just always be on, because these two pins of the button are always connected to each other, whether or not the button is pressed. So clicking the button in this configuration does not do anything. So you now have your next assignment: design a circuit with two LEDs and two buttons, one to control each LED independently.